So today I'm going to be sharing with you how I cut an image into a shape. There's some people were asking how to do that, and there's many different ways of doing it, but this is just the way I learned and prefer to do it right now. And so the first thing you're going to do is come over here to the tools, and you're going to look for the shape tool. And basically it's this one right here, it could also look like any one of these shapes, because those are all the shape tools that we have in Photoshop and that come with the program. And so it just depends on which one's already selected. So it might look different. It might look like a line. So what you want to do is, to find the custom shape tool, you want to right click it, and then you want to come all the way down here to the bottom. And then you want to come up here to this toolbar up here and make sure it says shape, because if you bring down this little drop down menu, sometimes it's selected for path and pixels and shape, and the one we want is shape. Then the fill doesn't matter. I have it for black. It doesn't really matter what color you use, because it's not going to be part of the picture, so it doesn't really matter. And then for stroke, I'm just going to just not have a stroke for right now, and I'll probably change that later, but for right now I don't want to have any type of color, and stroke just kind of means the outline of the picture. And then you're going to go all the way here to the right, and you are going to come down here to this drop down menu, and you have a whole bunch of shapes there that you can pick from. If for some reason this is not, you don't see as many shapes as I have here, you need to come down to this little gear and click all, and then say okay, and then all these shapes should come up, because those are the ones that come with Photoshop, so they all are in there. You just kind of have to find them by clicking this gear. I'm going to pick the circle here, and that's the one I'm going to be using today. Now I'm going to get a photo from my most recent recent images is where you'll find your files of stuff that you've already, photos or whatever templates you've opened already in Photoshop. And I'm going to pick this picture of my son, because I'm going to be making a mug actually for my mother-in-law, and I'm going to use this picture to create the template for the mug. And so one little trick that I kind of learned, maybe some of you guys already know this, but since this is kind of for beginners, I wanted to share. When you create a document, sometimes it comes in like really big. And when you, I'm selecting the move tool now to move this picture over, but when you try to drag an image into the document, sometimes the picture is humongous. Let me show you what that looks like. I'm going to drag this picture now by clicking my mouse button into the document, and you're going to see how that comes in very large. And so it's huge, and it's just very difficult to sit here and find the edge. So basically, what you need to do is go over here to view, and there's print size, there's 200 if you want to really zoom into something to see some detail, but the one I like to use is called fit on screen, and that way when I bring in my picture, it's a lot easier to find the corners. So now I am going to click on the picture here, and I'm going to drag it on to the file, and now the corners are much easier to find. And let me see here. Here is the corner, and now I can resize, use this corner to resize my picture. But one thing you need to do, and just write it down, or make sure you always do this when you're resizing pictures, because if not, you will distort your picture, and it's just, you're thinking, oh my gosh, why is this not looking right. You have to hold down the shift button at all times when you're pulling in this this corner here. Let me show you what happens when you don't do that. As you're pulling it in, your picture starts getting distorted. See, it's not resizing equally on all sides. It's kind of just distorting it. So in order to avoid that, you must push down the shift button at all times. And it took me a while to learn that. I was like, I just like always thought, oh my gosh, why is this being distorted? But it wasn't, because I wasn't pushing down the shift button and holding it down as you're resizing it is very important. The first thing I need to do is to accept this transformation, even though I don't want to keep it. Photoshop won't let you go on until you go up here and click this check or until you press enter. So for me, enter is usually faster. So now I'm going to resize this picture correctly, but I want to undo my last steps. And so a nice shortcut is Control Alt Z. You just keep on holding down the Control and Alt, and you just click Z to go back. So it takes a little while to practice, but you want to just practice that. So it's a nice shortcut to use, so you don't have to, you know, so you can just go back your steps and undo your last steps. So now I'm gonna hold down the shift key at all times and don't let it go, and I'm going to get this arrow in the corner and just drag it down, holding the shift key at all times, drag it down again, not letting go of the shift key, and dragging it down again. And now I just let go of the shift key and moving the picture here with the mouse, dragging it over. So now I'm ready to use the shape tool, and I'm going to go over here again and click that shape tool. And here Photoshop is telling me once again, when you try to resize a picture, you always have to accept the transformation. And right here you can push apply, but once again there's a check mark up here, or you just have to press enter. Now you can go to the shape tool and click it if it's not clicked already, and you'll have a little plus right there. Well, it's kind of hard to see, but you're going to click your mouse button and drag the shape over your picture. It doesn't really matter if it's not perfect in the right spot, because you're going to be able to move this now, and after we also make it into a circle, you can also move it then. And so I have my shape tool now, which is a circle, and I have three layers here on the right. And what I want to do in order to make this image into the shape, I'm going to have to click this layer where the photo is, and I'm gonna have to click it and hold my mouse button down and put it above the shape. And now I see the photo, and it looks like the shape isn't there, but it's actually hiding behind the photo. So you're always gonna see what's on the very top, and it's is gonna be hiding the layer underneath. And so now I'm going to go up to where the picture is and right click and do create clipping mask, and that is going to make my image the shape. And in order to move this picture, because now I see that it's kind of I want to center my son more, I'm going to go over here to the left and click the move tool, and now I can resize it and drag it around to any which way I want. And I can also even come down, come over here and hold down the shift key again and drag it to make it smaller or bigger, the actual photo, and then reposition it again. You know, that's basically how you can do that. Let's say I wanted to reposition Here we go again with the check mark. So let's say I wanted to reposition the shape because the shape was too big. Then I go over to the layers palette and make sure that the shape is selected, and I can also didn't push down the shift. I also have to push down the shift and then make this circle smaller too. And you could do it that way. If you have it on the picture, you can resize the picture and make it larger and smaller. And so push enter to accept that. And right now, since my picture is selected, I'm moving the picture around. So you could resize either one. And now what I'd like to do is show you how to add that stroke, that outline to this picture. And you go again to the shape tool, and then we're going to go up to the stroke. And that's basically outline. I think outline makes more sense to me, but you're going to click it, and then you're basically going to make sure that your shape layer is selected, because if not, then it won't work. So then you're going to be able to pick whatever color you want. See, it goes to this color, yellow, blue, whatever you want, black. But let's say you want to coordinate with a color that's already in your picture. What you're going to do is come over here to this little triangle color picker area and click it, and then this little window is going to pop up. And you're going to be able to pick the color that you want by taking this little dropper and putting it wherever you want. I want it to match this blue, and so I'm going to select this color and push OK, and then the outline is going to be in the color that I selected. Right now, I think that the outline is a little bit too thick, so I want to come over here to this little tool here and drag it down a bit so that it makes the outline bigger or smaller. I don't like it that big. I like it very faint. You can also come in here and type in the number you want, and it also works that way. So that's pretty much how I outline the picture and how I make it into a specific shape for any project that I'm working on. And maybe I'll do a follow-up video that kind of shows how I put it into the mug template. Hopefully this was helpful.